Hey guys, Cece back with another video, and today's video is going to be a rapid review. Watching me, make sure you go ahead and click that subscribe button, click the notification bell, follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my family vlog channel at Bradley TV. The links are all down below. Y'all already know what to do. I shouldn't even have to tell y'all, but in case you don't, there you go. So let's get into this video. I'm excited to be doing this video because I feel like I'm always hauling products. In fact, you guys will see a haul in a minute, if not right after this, right before this, with this makeup on. I literally just filmed another haul for you guys, but I feel like I'm always hauling stuff, and then sometimes I don't get a chance to come back and circle back around and tell you what I think of the products that I hauled. So I want to start doing that. So if you guys like this video, if you like this idea, give it a thumbs up, comment down below and let me know that you like this video idea, and also let me know about some products that you saw me haul that I haven't circled back on that you want to know more about. All right, and I will add those to the next one because I think I'm gonna add this as a regular series on my channel. So let me know what you think about that. But anyway, I chose 7 products that I have here in this basket that I have not yet updated you on with my thoughts. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that today. These are going to be quick, rapid reviews, but just so you guys get a little taste of how I feel about the product. So let's jump in and get started. First things first is this new Juvia's Place I Am Magic Velvety Matte Foundation. So I did do a first impressions on this foundation. If you guys have not seen that, click that I right up there. It'll take you right to that video. But this product has been all the rage, and for good reason. I did a wear test on my Instagram. It's highlighted in my Instagram stories. So just make sure you're following me there because I have been doing a lot of product reviews on Instagram. But I did a wear test with this foundation, so head over there and check that out. And I was thoroughly impressed, okay? I'm not gonna talk about it too much because I did give you all my thoughts on Instagram, but this foundation is amazing. And if you have not gotten it yet, you should get it. That's what I'm going to say, okay? And I have highly, highly oily skin, as you guys know. I got it in the shade Havana number 420, if you use me as a shade reference. Next product we're gonna talk about is the Fenty Beauty Pro Kisser Luscious Lip Balm in Hint Hint. So lip balm has kind of been my obsession for like the last year. I have been going apeshit over lip balm and the Laneige, you guys know I love the Bite Beauty Agave Lip Mask. You guys know I have fallen in love with as well. So Fenty has ranked right up there with my faves, and for good reason. This is such a good moisturizing lip balm. I kind of use it as a lip prep, so I keep it back there in my vanity, and as I'm getting ready, as I'm doing my makeup, before I put on my lip product, I will put this on and just let it sit on my lips and make my lips all nice and soft and supple, getting ready for whatever lip product that I'm going to apply. So this is like kind of been my baby lately, and really taking the place of the other two. Not taking the place, because I still use those, but this one, I feel like I'm gonna have to get a few more of these to keep, like one in the purse, one upstairs in my nightstand, one in here. Like I just need a few of these, but this is amazing. Next product, I just got a little sample of it, but this is the Banana Bright Face Primer by Ole Henriksen, or is it Ola Henriksen? I don't know. I've heard people say it a million different ways, but this is that Banana Bright Face Primer that everyone has been talking about. Kind of smells like bananas, but everyone has been talking about this face primer, so I went and got a little sample of it at Sephora, and this sample lasts you a while. I've used this like 3 times already, and I still have a good amount in here, and this is not for anyone with oily skin. If you have oily skin, just run. Like if you see it here, you wanna be over here, okay? That is how you want to react to this primer if you have oily skin. Now if you have dry skin, honey, go for it. It definitely brightened up my face, but it also made me greasy as hell. So that's just a fair warning. I will not be purchasing the Banana Bright Face Primer, and I almost purchased it. I swear to God, I almost purchased it. And I was like, I'm gonna get a little sample of it first. And I did that, and I'm so happy because this is just not for me. But two primers that are for me, I have the Milk Hydro Grip Primer, which has been all the rage. And then I also have the Farsali Skin Tune Blur Primer. So these two, I don't love them separately. I like them, they're okay. Don't really love them separately, but these two together are a powerhouse. That's what I'm wearing on my face today underneath my makeup. And what I will do is apply the Farsali Skin Tune Blur first, and I'll just apply it in the areas that I really want blurred and need to keep matte. So like my nose area, my cheek area, like right here on both sides, and then some on the chin. I'll apply a little bit of this first, and then I'll go in with the Milk Hydro Grip Primer, and I'll apply that to like the cheek area as well as a little bit on the forehead and then a little bit on the chin. I do avoid the nose, but I kind of get the rest of the perimeter of my face, and my makeup stays all day flawlessly with no problems. I mean, these two together are amazing. And y'all know I got the little mini sizes because they do have the mini sizes in both of these. And I'm just so happy I tried these primers. I was kind of steering clear of the Milk Hydro Grip because it was called Hydro. And I was like, ooh, anything that has the word Hydro in it, especially in the summertime, probably not for me. But mixed with the Farsali, I have gotten great results. And this primer gets like super tacky, so you could just feel like your makeup gripping to it, which is awesome because you know your makeup's gonna be on your face all day. The next product that I've been loving is the Cover FX. This is the Monochromatic Blush Duo in Spiced Cinnamon. Been absolutely loving this. Oh, I love Cover FX face products. Do they even have eye products? I don't even know if they have eye products, but I love all of their face products. I don't think I've had a bad Cover FX product. But you know what? I do not use this side. This side I feel like is just gonna be a total waste, but this blush is everything, like everything. It's so pretty on the cheeks, and I think it looks great for this time of year, just with like some soft spring-like, summer-like makeup, just like some really soft light makeup. You throw on a nice pop of blush on your cheeks and all of a sudden everything just comes together, honey. So I really love this blush. I've been using it a lot lately, and I think this is a great buy if you're thinking about buying it. Last but not least, another love of mine is the new Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin Powder Foundation. You guys, I've been using this like every day. Like every day. This has been seriously my everyday setting powder. I added it to my Shop My Stash this month. So I added this product to my Shop My Stash this month, which has really made me like really tackle it and use it and try it. And Lori, am I happy I did that, because I've just been in love, seriously using it every single day. I'm using it today. I wear it as a setting powder on top of my foundation. I have worn it alone. I have worn it to touch up my foundation. I mean, I've worn it every which way, and this powder has never let me down. So today I'm wearing a combination of this powder along with the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin Liquid Foundation. And it just is such a nice summer kind of glowy look. That foundation isn't super matte. It says it's matte, but it's not super matte throughout the day on me. And so I get this kind of really pretty, almost natural, glowy look when I wear that foundation. And then I pair this on top, and it just looks better as the day goes on. You know, the foundation as it's worn, as my oils mix in with it, it just starts to look better as the day goes on. And this is definitely such a big part of that. So I'm loving this powder foundation, and I am in the shade Y445 if you're interested. So that is it, y'all. That is the end of this video. I hope you guys liked this video and it gave you a little insight into some of the products that I have hauled lately that I haven't gotten a chance to really circle back around and tell you guys about. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also, if you watched till the end, go ahead and subscribe. Obviously, you like me. Go ahead and subscribe to this channel. I would love to have you join the family. It would mean the world to me. I love you guys so, so much. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye, you guys.